Hey guys, hi, welcome back. This is Saurabh and we are learning loops. We are learning Java loops, and the while loop is the first loop which we're gonna learn today. So this is the syntax, how we write a while loop in a Java. First is while, which is a keyword, and you guys know that Java is a case sensitive, so you can't write W capital and H-I-L-E in small, you know, or entire while in caps. It has to be small because it's a Java keyword and they are case sensitive. So you should be writing while, and then there has to be some condition. We will see how to write these conditions, and this condition is gonna return a boolean, either true or false, and based on that we're gonna enter this particular code lines to be executed. If this particular condition is true, then only it will execute whatever is inside your while loop. And then once it is done, then it will again jump and again check for a condition. And if it is again true, then it will again execute and so on. So this loop is gonna continue. We will see the execution flow, how it's gonna look like. So let's say if this is the syntax, how the execution flow will actually work. So as I said, first it will check for a condition, whatever condition you have. If that condition is true, then it will execute your code statements or whatever code lines you have inside that for loop. And then after it's done, so let's say after it reached here, again it will jump back to check the condition. Again it will check, and if it's again true, then it will again enter and execute the code line and so on. So loop is gonna continue unless this condition is false, and the moment this condition is false, then it will exit the loop and it will come out of a loop. Okay, so let's see a practical example, or let's see how we exactly write it. So let's say in Java programming, I'm gonna create a new class. Let's name this as while loop, and we need a main method. That's why I'm checking this. Click finish. Okay, so this is a main method, and inside this main method we're gonna write directly a while loop. So just a comment, while loop understanding. Okay, now as I said, if you try to write while like this, right, it's not gonna understand, because you know Java is case sensitive. You need to make sure you're writing exactly in the same keywords in a small case. So let's say while. See, the moment I wrote while in small letter, the color of that particular while changed automatically, right? Because it's a keyword. If you see, all these keywords are highlighted in a specific color. So that's where you will learn, when you're writing a code, if something is a keyword, it will automatically change a color on its own, right? So the moment I give E capital, see, the color is black. So this small things you will learn when you write more and more code. So before I write a while loop, let me initiate a variable int x equal to 0. See, the int, again it's a Java keyword which indicates it's, you know, integer data type. So that's why the color changed. Now I'm saying while, I need to write a condition inside this, right? I'll write it later on, and then I opened the bracket and closed it, and here CISO control space in order to get a system.println, and just click enter. So these are some kind of shortcuts, and I'm saying value of x, and I'm gonna append that. So after double quotes plus, again control space, so it will give you all the list of variables currently available for you to access, and you select x from this, or you can copy paste as well, but this is more efficient way of coding whenever you're writing. Now here what I need to write a condition, so I'm saying x less than 5. So basically I'm saying while x is less than 5, keep on executing this. And in this, we are just printing the value of x. Now you will say, Saurabh, you have defined x as 0, which is yes, which is less than 5. So it will execute this statement. And then again, this is gonna be an infinite loop. If I don't do something in this, it will keep on executing, because you are not changing the value of x. And you have initialized the value of x as 0, and it will keep on executing. So this is very dangerous in programming. Okay. So make sure whenever you are reviewing someone else's code, or when you are writing your code, especially when you are using loops, you have to make sure to address these three things. First is, you are not in any condition, you are not gonna end up in an infinite loop. The next thing is, your condition at least meets true, or you know, it makes sense to execute the code in some condition. It's not like you're writing any condition which is very weird, which will never be true. So unnecessary, you know, the code lines will never execute. And the third thing is, you have a specific logic to control your iteration. So we will see this when we will learn an advanced loops in our next sessions. But right now, for a simple loop like this, you need to iterate, you need to increment the value of x. So there are multiple ways with which you can do that. X equal to x plus 1. So what I'm doing, in every iteration, I'm increasing the value to 1. So for the first iteration, it will be 0. The next iteration, and then at the end of first iteration, the value of x will be 0 plus 1, which is 1. The next, it will be 2, 3, 4, and so on, right? So it will execute till 4, and the moment it becomes 5, this condition is no more gonna be true. That's why it will come out of the loop and it will execute this. So let's say I'm again writing one more statement. Here I'm saying, jumped out of while loop, just for us to understand that, you know, it exited the while loop. See, my while loop started here and ended here. How to find out if you have multiple? Just click on the starting braces and it will highlight automatically where you end, or double click there. It will highlight the complete portion which is inside your while loop. Okay, so just double click in the start and it will highlight. Similarly, the main method where it starts, double click here, it will highlight. So with this, you can understand what portion of a code is inside which method or which loop. Okay, now this is the one way to increment. Another way is just give x plus plus. Okay, so x plus plus is nothing but x equal to x plus 1, right? Both are same. Now I'm gonna run this program for you. So right click, run as Java program. See, the value of x is 1 for the first iteration, right? And then, sorry, the value of the first one is 0, then 1, 2, 3, and 4. If you see, after it executed the 4, it would have incremented the value of x to 5, and now the condition is no more true. That's why it didn't execute that particular print statement for the 5th time, and that's why it came out of a loop and it printed jumped out of while loop, right? So this is one very simple example of, you know, how to write a while loop and how to control the execution. If I don't write this, I'm gonna show you now how it's gonna. So this may end up in an infinite loop, which, you know, which is very dangerous. See this, it is continuously it is executing, right? It's not gonna end because there is no condition which will meet and make that condition as false. That's why the while loop is keep on executing. So I'm gonna stop this. But yes, you have to make sure that, you know, you have a condition which will make sure that it executes up to certain limit and after that it stops. Okay, so this is one very simple example for the while loop. And the next session, we're gonna learn about do while loop. Okay, so see you in the next session. Bye.